Welcome to the Phytech booth. I am Martin Schwan and I am working on update and device management. And we are a group of developers working on this system, and we provide you with a mechanism to keep your Phytech hardware up to date. And this is what we do.
So it's all about secure updates, easy
yes.
updates?
Yes, so the main advantage of our product is that we provide an easy way and a secure way to update your Phytech hardware. And we do this by adjusting our BSP, so you have not the hard work to do, so we do it for you.
All right.
And, yeah.
So why do you need to update devices?
Well, the obvious reason is for security reasons. Because you always want to have the latest security updates on your device, and you want to do this quite often. So you have to have some kind of automatic system that does this for you. And there are other obvious reasons, like updating because you just want to fix your bugs in your application, for example.
So why are people choosing Phytech? Is this a big part of it?
It's a main part of our BSP, our board support package, that we provide with our hardware. So this is also the advantage. If you buy a hardware from us, it's a standard part of it. And you don't have to pay any extra fees for it. It's a standard part for it, and you get the support by it by default.
But what's different between the updating and the lifecycle management, or is it very related?
It's very related,
fee,
yes.
Right?
The lifecycle management is about the whole process. It's about supporting your software for a long time, and then the update and device management process is about actually updating your device. So updating the BSP on the hardware.
And so is it updating now, or? What's happening now? Are you triggering something
right.
in there?
So we have already started a rollout, and we see that one of four devices already got updated, and the other ones are about to update in a minute or so. So we might see it also on the screens.
So how does the update process work?
So we have two main components. On the boards, we have the update client itself. We are using Rauk for this. This is the robust auto update controller. It's a product from Pengutronics. And the other component is Hawkbit that we see on the screen. It's the interface for managing your devices. We can also list the different devices here. We have four boards and two different software versions for the demo. And we can start a rollout that we just did, and this will automatically update the devices.
Is this industry standard kind of software? Do you develop this whole UI, or did you work together with the supplier?
So the interface is an Eclipse project, so this is also open source software. We did not do any adjustments on it, and but we plan to do some in the future, and this is all going upstream. So everything that you see here, the software, the components that we use, is all open source.
And so what's going to happen in the future? What do you think?
One great thing we are working on that's coming in the next months is differential updates. So this is the way it works, is that we only update the part that changed. So this saves very much on the bandwidth and makes the update faster. And the other things is that we want to make this whole system as easy as possible.
What do your customers say thus far about how easy it is to use?
This is a project we just started, but we already had some very interesting talks to some customers, and I think they like them.